Goodbye, naughty little monkeys. My next guest is a two-time Oscar nominee for the movies Educating Rita and Billy Elliot. Her new film, Driving Lessons, opens on October the 13th. Take a look at this clip.
For a boy of 17, you show a lamentable lack of curiosity. No doubt you're suppressed by your upbringing, but that's hardly enough to explain what frankly amounts to little short of social autism. I shall have to imagine your curiosity for you. You're a healthy 17-year-old boy. You're not, of course. You take my point. You see an attractive woman living on her own. You wonder, is she a roaring lesbian? Answer no. For your information, I've been married and divorced 3 times.
Please welcome Julie Walters, everybody. Julie?
Hello.
How are you?
I'm all right. Well, I'm a bit let-jagged, but...
Let-jagged? Have you just come in from London?
What?
London?
Yes,
have you come from London?
I have, yes, on Monday, so I'm completely knackered, really. I've made an effort, and I'm...
What does knackered mean? A lot of the Americans don't know what knackered mean. Please tell them what knackered means.
Well, it means, really, when you're at the end, when it's, you're spent.
Yeah.
They do it to horses. They take off their... we can't say that.
No, you can say the knackers is a term that's used for part
bollocks.
Of a, yeah, bollocks, yeah.
Basically.
Yeah.
See. I like the way they all stood up when I came.
Yes.
I like that. Shows manners.
It's very, very nice. They're very, they're all wearing ankle bracelets though, if you can see that. In that clip from that movie, wasn't that the Ron Weasley from the Harry Potters?
My boy.
Yeah. And don't you do the Harry Potter with him? Aren't you?
I'm his mum.
Yeah, in Harry Potter.
I am.
And then you're in another film with him. I can't control my craziness. What the? It's so weird.
We're not having an affair.
No, really.
But we are together. Yeah, so it's lovely to be with someone that you've been with before.
Yeah.
Who get my bees wet.
Yeah. I it's nice, it's kind of, you know... But you've watched him grow up into the fine, red-haired young man he is,
isn't it? I know, yeah. Yeah. No, he is, and he's fantastic in the film.
He's really... a good actor, that kid, actually. Even the first Harry Potter film, I thought, oh, I know, that kid can act that one there.
Yeah.
The red-haired one. The rest of them, the red-haired one, I thought, no, he's good.
Yeah, no, he's really good. He's really grown up in this.
Yeah.
But, I mean, when I knew I was doing it with him, there was a scene in it where I'm completely drunk, you know, and he has to lift me up. And I thought, oh, that little boy, you know, he's got to pick me up and I've got to be dead, you know, dead weight and everything. He's got to be... My God, he's huge.
Yeah.
He's huge and really fit and massively whipped me up off the floor, you know, no problem, about 19 times, not even out of breath.
Really?
So, yeah.
Do you think you could pick me up?
Yeah. God, are you heavy?
I'm very heavy, yes. I'm a very fat man.
I am
a very fat man. Listen, do you get a lot of people recognising you from the Harry Potter things? Do you get a lot of people...
I have children for the first time
recognising,
which I never used to have before. It was usually their parents. They say, that's Mrs. Weasley.
Yeah.
And the kids usually go... No, it's not. I say, no, it's not, because I wear the padding, you know, in it.
Yeah.
And so I have these massive bosoms full of birdseed.
That's very popular in LA.
Is it?
Massive birdseed.
Yeah.
You can't... Birds here are starving for want of seed.
Well, they were just from Pamela Anderson.
Yeah, that's from Pamela Anderson and the rest. She's Pamela Rock now. She married Kid Rock. Yeah, Pamela Anderson married Kid Rock, so she must be Pamela Rock. Or Pamela Kid. Or Kid Pamela. I can't keep up.
No, for goodness sake.
Yeah, I can't keep... Do you follow the celebrities in the gossip magazines? Do you enjoy that?
No, not really. Oh, there are loads of them, though, in England now.
Yeah, they do. They're even worse in England than they are here. They're all over the place in England.
Trying to get pictures of people's knickers getting into cars.
Yeah. Well, I do that, but it's not... That's just for myself. That's for my own kind of personal... Now, you still live in England, don't you?
I do.
Yeah. What do you live in the centre of London or outside?
No,
or
I live in the country on a farm.
On a farm? Really?
I do.
Do you have a farm? Do you have farm animals? Do you have...
Yeah.
What kind?
We've got cattle.
Cattle?
We've got pigs, sheep, chickens.
How lovely.
Vegetables.
Vegetables are not animals.
No.
Yeah.
No.
So don't go trying to herd them.
No, it's no good. I've tried.
Yeah. After you don't herd your vegetables.
No.
Steam your vegetables.
Steam that's... them. Or have them work on the farm.
Yeah. Do you eat the animals that you have on the farm?
Yeah.
Really?
We do. But they have a nice life.
Right.
But...
Well, that's fair enough.
Yeah. We're very kind to them.
I think that's fair enough.
You know, you're going to eat them, so you'll be nice to
them. Yeah, you'll be nice to go, are you enjoying that grass? Eat up. Yeah. Very nice. So you don't give them names then? You don't say, oh, this is, Roger.
No. When we first moved to the country, we had two pigs, Pinky and Perky.
Right.
And, No, that's not a good idea. Because, I mean, when my daughter was little, we had all the cousins round and everyone. We were eating the Sunday lunch. And my daughter said, this is Pinky's leg.
Oh.
And her cousin was sick.
Oh, dear, really?
Her cousin threw up, yeah. So, I hate that.
So you only took the leg off and got a little wooden leg for the peg out?
Yeah. They get around very well.
They get around. A skateboard or something.
Yeah, no, they do. They can hop quite well. Two legs is more difficult.
Two legs.
They have to be, alternate legs. Otherwise, they won't stand a chance.
Yeah. People are going to hate us for saying this about pigs.
I know.
The pig lovers of America are going to rise up against us.
Oh no, don't! I love animals.
Yeah,
actually.
No, you do. You do love animals.
Do.
And that's why you eat them.
They're good for me.
No, they are. They are.
Yeah,
good.
Yeah,
and you give them a nice life, and that's lovely. So do you enjoy being in America? Is that something you do often?
I love coming to America.
It's nice, isn't it? I like America.
Yeah. Yes, because it's kind of magic still. It's kind of like being brought up, isn't it, on films and television, American films. It's like...
I know,
kind of in love with it.
It's fantastic.
Really.
I sometimes think the Americans take it for granted. That they walk around, kind of, and I sometimes see a car wash here and go, oh my God, look at that, it's like a cartoon.
Yeah,
you know, and
I know.
All the colours and the thing. And,
yeah. Oh God, no, it's always a huge shock. I mean, the first time I came, I stayed, I'll never forget it, staying at the Beverly Hills Hotel.
Oh, all Americans stay there when they're in town.
It's so posh.
Yeah, it's very posh, yeah.
I mean, I've never seen so much gold around a swimming pool. Those people dived in, it was the one that ever came up.
Yeah.
It was just extraordinary sort of stuff, really. But anyway, so the whole thing of it is just, it's just bigger than everything in England.
Yeah,
you know?
And the teeth are a lot nicer, I notice, as
the
well.
The teeth are a lot nicer and whiter. Is it really? Let's have a look at yours. Oh, they're good teeth.
Well, most of them don't belong to me. They're,
they're
CBS teeth. I borrow them from a guy called Bob Barker who works in the other thing. We have to go. Listen, good luck with the film.
Thank you.
And thanks for being on our show. We'll talk to you again very soon, I hope. Julie Walters, everybody. We'll be right back.